Question number 3 from exercise 10.3. 10.3. In 10.3, the third question says, the third question is like this. I think you are able to see the screen now. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Sir.
Now, this is the fourth session in circles. Question number 3 from exercise 10.3. If two circles intersect at two points, then prove that their centers lie on the perpendicular bisector of the common chord. See, there are two circles here, you can very well see. And when they are intersecting at A and B, two points, and we can join these two points, AB, then AB is a chord for this circle with center O, and with to this circle also with center O dash. For both of them, AB is a chord, therefore it is called a common chord. Okay, right? Then this any chord when a line is drawn from the center to the chord to bisect, okay, to bisect a chord, I am drawing a line here like this from O to AB, then it is perpendicular, is it not? And from O dash also to the same chord I will draw, that also is perpendicular. So you can see this angle is 90 degrees, the other side also the angle is 90 degrees, together it is 180 degrees. So this particular point of intersection of line joining the centers as well as the chord AB is lying on the line joining O and O dash. It is becoming a straight line. Therefore, clearly the line joining the centers, you can see the centers lie on the perpendicular bisector of the common chord. That's the thing we can write in our own words like this. Consider two circles centered at O, O dash, intersecting each other at point A and B respectively. Join AB. AB is the chord of the circle with center O, and perpendicular bisector AB passes through O. That is true. And again, AB is also chord to circle centered at O dash. Therefore, perpendicular bisector passes through O again for AB. So both the bisectors are passing through the centers now. Clearly, the centers of these circles lie on the perpendicular bisectors of the common chord. You can other way around, you can take this is 90 degrees, this also 90 degrees. Totally, it is 180. Therefore, O, you can put one letter M here. OMB is 90 degrees. You can write this is M. M is the point of intersection. Since a perpendicular bisector you are drawing here, and perpendicular bisector passes through O here. OM passes through O. OM, O dash M also passes through O. This is 90 degrees here, and this is also 90 degrees. Together, 90 plus 90 equal to 180. So O angle O M O dash angle O M O dash, this total angle will be 180 degrees. Therefore, they lie on the straight line. You can say this way also. Now remember this one. Perpendicular bisector passes through the center. All right. Now let us go with another important question. How do you decide? So for example, let me draw a line here first and tell you about this one. Say this is a line segment only we take. Line segment. And here is a point. What is the distance between this point and this line? Can you say, I will take some points here. I will take some points here on this and join these points to this line. Is this the distance between the line and this point?
Yes,
is this the line, this one? Is this the line distance? Is this the distance? Is this the distance? What is the distance between the point here? Say I am going to name it. I put name here. It is H. and say this is L. Line L and H, what is the distance? Is this distance, this or this or this or this? We are not sure. So we have to take a perpendicular first. Perpendicular to this one, passing through this H, passing through this point, and the point of introduction and intersection of this perpendicular and the line here, and the distance between these two, say K, HK is the distance between, HK is the distance between the line and the point H. Whenever we talk about distance between two points, or a line and a point, a line segment and a point, etc., it is the perpendicular distance. It is the shortest distance always. It is the perpendicular distance. Remember this one. Okay. Now, I think I can close. Yes. Now, here is a theorem. 10.6 actually, it is not 10.4, 10.6. Okay, let it be. We change it. 10.6, I think. Yeah. Equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. This is the center, and the distance between the center and chord AB, chord CD, you have to find. How do you find? You have to draw a perpendicular. I have drawn OL and OM. Are they perpendiculars or not? They are perpendiculars. Therefore, OL is the distance between AB, OM is the distance between CD and O. Okay? OL is the distance between AB and O, the center, and OM is the distance between CD and the center O. Now, are they equal or not? We have to check. Okay? Firstly, you can check AB is 4.48, CD is also 4.48. The chords are equal. Chords are equal. Equal chords we have here. And we have drawn the perpendiculars. Now we have to check whether OL equal to OM or not. Let us check that. OL equal to 2 units, OM also is 2 units. You may tell me, you have fixed everything, sir, you are only showing a cinema. No. Let me change the chords here. You see, the distances are also changing. Since the chords are of the same length, the distances are also of the same. See, I am changing the length of the chord. Same, both the lengths are equal. AB is equal to CD. Even then the distance OL is equal to OM. You can very well check here. Even I can do like this also. Two chords can take any place here. Okay, any place, see, the distance is same, right? Anywhere the chords can be placed, the distance are equal. So what can you tell? Equal chords of a circle are equidistant from the center. Equidistant from the center. This is very well understood by all of us now. So for this particular theorem, practical proof or experimental proof is enough. We don't need to prove it theoretically. Theoretically also, if you want, you can prove very easy. Simple. Join OA and OD. You have got two triangles here. I will tell you, these angles are equal here. 90 degrees, 90 degrees. And OA equal to OD. Why? Because they are radii, and perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. That means half of this chord is equal to half of this chord. That means AL equal to AM. So by right angle, hypotenuse side, RHS, RHS, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, OL equal to OM. Corresponding parts are equal. That way we can put the theoretical proof also. Of course, theoretical proof is not required, therefore Therefore, I am not writing it here on the board. Now, we should move on to the exercise. Did you understand this particular concept?
Yes, sir.
One more thing I want to
tell. Yes, sir.
In reverse, if you tell the statement, suppose you tell the statement in reverse, that there are two cards which are equidistant from the center of a circle. There are two cards which are equidistant from the center of a circle, center of the circle. Then the lengths of cards are equal. Equal cards are equidistant. Equidistant cards are equal cards. Equidistant cards are equal in length. This can be told in reverse. So that is also true. That is also true. That can also be proved. Now I am closing this. Next we'll go back to the presentation. This one here. Now exercise 10.4, first one. Two circles 5 centimeters and 3 centimeters intersect at two points and the distance between their centers is 4 centimeters. Find the length of their common chord. Now to see the answer, we'll go back to GeoGebra. I have a link here. We'll go back again. Check here. And this is the file here now, children. Two circles. The pink colored circle or the red colored circle is 5 centimeters radius. And this blue colored circle is of radius 3 centimeters. And this is the center of this particular circle. O is the circle, center of circle, pink colored circle. P is the center of blue colored circle. Now, we need to find the length of their common chord. Firstly, the points of intersection we take. These two are intersecting at A and B. Now, let me join A and B. That is the chord for the red circle as well as blue circle. Therefore, it is the common chord. It is the common chord. Let me draw the radius, one of the radii of the red circle, that is OA. It is 5 centimeters because it is given already. Then we know AB is the radius of the blue circle. It is 3. Now observe, children. 3, 4, 5, and they are the sides of a triangle. What comes to your mind, you tell me, by seeing this triangle and the numbers?
Right angle.
Very good, very good. Whoever told about Pythagoras, they are all good. They are all good. Pythagorean triplets, and it is a right triangle. Okay, these three are Pythagorean triplets. Center, now let us do that one now. Circle with center O is of 5 centimeters radius. Circle with center P is of 3 centimeters radius. AB is their common chord. Distance between the centers is given as 4 centimeters, OP. Now 3, 4, 5 forms a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, 3, 4, 5, actually it should be form. English is wrong here, English grammar. So let me correct. Here, 3, 4, 5, numbers 3, 4 and 5 form a Pythagorean triplet. 3 square plus 4 square, that is 9 plus 16 is 25. 25 means 5 square. Therefore, triangle OPA is right angled at P. Right angled at P here. 3 square plus 4 square is 5 square. So, it is right angle here. When this is right angle here, when OPA is right angle, that means OP is perpendicular to AB and OP is perpendicular to AB and perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. Agreed? Perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. OP is perpendicular to AB. Therefore, OP bisects the chord AB. Therefore, if chord is AB and half of the chord is 3, then length of the chord will be 2 times of 3 units, that is 6 centimeters now. AB, length of AB is 2 times of PA because P is the midpoint now. PA is half of it. So 2 times PA, that is 2 times 6 centimeters is the answer here. Did you understand this problem?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You can take a screenshot or make a note quickly. Then we'll move on to the second problem. This is the second question. If two equal chords of a circle intersect within the circle, prove that the segments of one chord are equal to the corresponding segments of the other chord. It is a very, very important problem. It is coming in two slides. Both the slides you can take a screenshot or write immediately whenever I complete the particular explanation. Now let us take a circle with center O. Two chords PQ and RS, they are of same length, and I am drawing perpendiculars from O, that is the center, to the chords. Perpendicular from the center bisect the chord, and equal chords are equidistant, therefore OU equal to OV. OU equal to OV. PQ and RS are equal chords. Draw perpendiculars OV and OU to the chords. And in these two triangles now, OU equal to OV equal to OU, because they are the distances of equal chords. Next, we can say OT is a common side, and angle OBT equal to angle OUT equal to 90 degrees. By construction, you can understand that OT is common, just now I told you. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by R lecture's congruence. Up to here, you understand. And take a screenshot immediately. Therefore, BT, the segment BT is equal to segment UT by CPCT. These are the two triangles we are talking about, children. One triangle is this, another triangle is this one. In both, one right angle is there, one common side is there, and the distances are equal here. So by RHS, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, this VT and UT are equal. Okay, that is what I have made here. That is point number one. This point number one is very, very important for us to prove the particular thing. Okay, actually, did you understand what is the meaning of this question? Equal chords are intersecting here.
Yes, sir.
Equal chords are intersecting here, and the point, that means the parts are equal here. What are those parts, segments? What are the segments made by this by intersection here? See, for example, this is the part here. See, these two are meeting at P. Then RT is a part, is a segment of RS, and TS is another segment. So RT, again, like just like that, PT is one segment, TQ is one segment. RT is equal to PS, and TS is equal to TQ. PR, TP, TS, TQ. They are equal, you have to prove. Okay, you understand? Now let us go back. Let us take this first, what we proved. BT equal to UT, we proved just now. We proved just now in the previous one. That I have taken into the next slide. And the same figure I am putting here again. Now, PQ equal to RS, that is given. Therefore, half of PQ equal to half of RS. What is half of PQ? It is nothing but PV. PV here, and half of RS is RU. Okay? Now, this also you keep in mind. Now, add equations 1 and 3. 1, this is 1. And this is 3. PV plus VT. This is PV and VT I am adding. PV plus VT. Is it not equal to PT? Similarly, RU plus UT. RU plus UT I am adding. Then I will get PT here, this side, and the other side I get RT. So PT equal to RT, the segments are equal. One thing is proved. Now we have to prove that ST equal to QT also. For that, what we do? We do like this. Now we subtract equation 4. Subtract equation 4 from equation 2. From PQ equal to RS, you subtract PT equal to RT. Very simple. From this, I am subtracting this one. What will I get? PT minus PQ, PQ minus PT is equal to RS minus RT. PQ, that is the segment for that is the chord given minus RT PT and RS that is the chord given minus RT will be the other segments QT and ST, and this is what we have proved, and therefore corresponding segments of the chords are equal when the chords intersect, equal chords intersect within the circuit.